Hello, and welcome to the launch of the 2025 Global Findex Database. My name is Anna Bierde, and I am the World Bank's Managing Director of Operations. Since its introduction in 2011, the Global Findex Database has become the world's most comprehensive resource on how adults use financial services to save, borrow, make payments, and manage risk. The database plays a vital role in tracking progress toward the global goals of ending extreme poverty and promoting shared prosperity. The 2025 edition builds on this legacy. Our team of researchers surveyed nearly 150,000 adults across more than 140 economies. This year's findings offer valuable insights into how individuals access and use digital banking services. They also highlight persistent disparities, particularly among women and low-income populations, in a financial landscape that is increasingly digital. Over the course of this event, we'll hear perspectives from policymakers around the world, get a first-hand look at how data is collected on the ground, and explore the key findings of this year's report. I'm confident that you will find the program both informative and engaging. Thank you for joining us.
The Global Findex 2025 shows how digital financial services and mobile technology are driving growth in financial access and usage and contributing to better financial health. In low and middle income economies, account ownership has increased to 75%, enabled by 84% of adults owning a mobile phone, three quarters of them smartphones. Women's account ownership in particular has nearly doubled since 2011, narrowing the persistent gender gap. However, for smartphones, a larger gap of 9 percentage points remains. Phones also drive digital financial use. Today, more than half of adults use their account with a mobile phone or a card, and 42% make digital payments for in-store and online purchases. Mobile financial services have also sparked a surge in formal saving, with 40% of adults now saving in accounts, up from 24% in 2021. Despite these advances, over 40% of adults find it difficult to secure extra money for emergencies, and many worry about monthly expenses or medical bills. Strengthening financial health could help the quarter of adults who have experienced emergencies in the form of a natural disaster or extreme weather, as two-thirds suffered income loss or damage to homes or livestock. The new Global Findex data reveal how mobile phones and the internet are enabling connection, access to information, and income generation, expanding opportunities for women, low-income, and rural adults, enhancing economic resilience and advancing participation in the digital economy. To explore these insights, download the World Bank's Global Findex 2025 report.
What we're doing now as part of ASEAN is actually we're trying to connect ASEAN up in a better form. So for example, an instant payment scheme. A merchant in Malaysia may want to be selling it across ASEAN, but payments, when it's done, people don't want to deal with foreign exchange. If you're a small merchant, having to go to the bank and then translate the cash into your own local currency is a real pain. But when you design the instant payment system, that settlement is done off the system. Yeah, so a merchant in Malaysia will receive ringgit, merchant in Indonesia will receive rupiah, and the transaction is displayed in the currency of the buyer. It facilitates, because then the person doesn't have to think, right? Well, what's the rate today? 4.31 multiplied by what is this? So providing ease and convenience actually motivates a lot of things along.
Nous avons
au
niveau de la région Gémois noté une très forte avancée de l'inclusion financière. Il faut aller vers les jeunes, il faut aller vers les femmes qui capacité d'accroître leur contribution à la production dans mon pays. Il faut aller davantage vers les zones rurales parce que les centres urbains sont relativement bien couverts, mais beaucoup plus d'attention doit être apportée. Vous savez, l'accès aux services financiers, c'est vital, c'est essentiel, c'est fondamental. À partir du moment où j'ai accès à un service financier, ça ouvre des perspectives. Des perspectives multiples et très, très larges. Je pense que ce sont des éléments importants. Et nous pensons qu'avec justement la plateforme d'interopérabilité régionale que nous allons bientôt lancer dans quelques semaines, je dirais, cette plateforme va permettre à tous les acteurs d'être interconnectés, quel que soit leur état. Banque, microfinance, établissement de monnaie publique et ainsi de suite. Et quel que soit le compte, ou de pouvoir faire des opérations.
Un secteur financier sólido et dynamique est fondamental pour que les pays aient un crecimiento sostenible au long du temps. Pero ese sector financiero debe ser también inclusivo. En el caso de Paraguay hemos logrado incorporar a mucha gente a los servicios financieros durante la última década. Y lo logramos a través de buenas políticas públicas. Por ejemplo, la creación de cuentas básicas con un acceso muy fácil para toda la población. El diseño de una estrategia nacional de inclusión financiera con pilares de educación, de inclusión y de protección al consumidor. La creación también de un sistema automático de pagos por parte del Banco Central. Es momento que con la tecnología no sea más la población la que llegue a los servicios financieros, sino que los servicios financieros lleguen a la población de manera automática.
Your day begins at around 6, you reach the field at around 7:30, you start work at around 8:39. There are days where you might find rainy seasons, you find roads have been wiped off, there are days where you might find there's no transport, so you have to improvise ways of reaching to the particular sampling areas. Generally, in a day, you are intended to at least speak to 5 successful respondents. They see research people and they think you're coming to sell to them something. But once you explain yourself clearly, then in more cases than not, ready to give you all the information that you need. Every day, every area, it's never the same. You never know what you'll encounter. It's unpredictable. You meet different cultures. All these are things that brings excitement to the field. One that I can remember, actually, it was in Kenya when we encountered a family of elephants that had decided just to park on the road. They were not in a hurry to move, keeping in mind I'm getting late to get the job done. When we see these reports and we see the impact, it brings some pride in you knowing that you're a part of it, bringing out people's perception from the ground, be able to bring advancement in their normal lives and be able to uplift their well-being.
Thanks, John, for sharing that snapshot of what life is like out in the field. Hundreds of interviewers like John from around the world spoke to the 145,000 adults in 141 economies who answered questions for the Global Findex. Since 2011, the Global Findex has been the world's definitive demand-side source of data on financial inclusion. It's become the go-to resource for understanding how people access and use financial accounts to save, borrow, make payments, and manage everyday needs and economic risks, including women, poor and young adults, and rural residents. This year, in addition to the Global Findex data on financial inclusion, we're excited to share findings from the very first Global Findex Digital Connectivity Tracker. It offers fresh insights into mobile phone ownership and internet use for a range of digital activities. What are the most interesting findings in the 2025 report? Number one, we've witnessed a remarkable transformation in financial inclusion in recent years, driven by the fact that 86% of adults worldwide own a mobile phone. This has enabled the rise in account ownership, including mobile money accounts, which are accessible via mobile phones and local agents, offering greater convenience for people without bank branches or ATM kiosks nearby. Since 2014, the share of adults in low and middle income economies who have any kind of account has increased from 55% to 75%. Mobile technology is driving financial inclusion, with most of the growth in account ownership attributed to mobile money accounts, used either independently or alongside traditional bank accounts. This shift is transforming how people manage their finances around the world. Number two, mobile accessible accounts are not only expanding access, they're also making it easier and more affordable to use. Today, 40% of adults save formally in an account, a two-thirds increase since 2021. Sub-Saharan Africa is seeing especially strong progress, with the share of adults who save rising to 35%, a 50% increase in 2021. Mobile technology is also key to saving. Nearly one in four adults in the region now save using a mobile money account, nearly double the share from 2021. Number three, digital payments are growing. Receiving money directly into an account is now more common than getting paid in cash. In low and middle income economies, nearly 75% of government payment recipients and half of private sector employees now receive their wages, pensions, or social transfers directly into an account. This shift strengthens financial security, especially for women. Digital purchases are also becoming part of daily life. By 2024, 42% of adults had made a digital payment to a merchant, up from 35% in 2021, highlighting how cards and phones are increasingly being used for in-store and online transactions. Number four, smartphones are the primary way people access the internet, with 90% of internet users relying on them to get online. Beyond managing financial accounts, people are using the internet to connect on social media, read news, learn new skills, access government information and services, search for jobs, and even earn income online. But women are 9 percentage points less likely than men to have a smartphone, and costs remain the biggest barrier to phone ownership. For many, the high price of purchasing and using a smartphone limits access not just to financial services, but to the broader digital economy. Number five, many adults still struggle to cope with financial shocks and protect their financial health. While more people now own and use financial accounts, this hasn't yet translated into greater financial resilience. Only 56% of adults could access extra money in an emergency, like a job loss or unexpected medical bill. And just half could manage their finances for 2 months or more if they lost their main source of income. These latest findings highlight a new era in financial inclusion. Mobile technology is a powerful driver, expanding access to digital financial services. To accelerate progress, governments and the private sector must continue investing in mobile infrastructure and product innovation. Equally important is strengthening consumer protection, developing fast and interoperable payment platforms, implementing national identification systems, and promoting financial education. Ensuring people can effectively use these financial and digital services and participate fully in the digital economy.
India's success in technology, whether you look at the payment systems or whether you look at credit delivery systems, whether you look at digital identity, all have been made possible largely by following a model that can be called as digital public infrastructure model. So digital infrastructures are created in the public sector, and then access to those is provided to innovators, including the fintech and startup ecosystem and the banks. Everyone can have access. And that ensures that the efficiency that the fintech ecosystem has in innovating, which a government system or a central bank system will not have, can be utilized best. At the same time, the basic technology infrastructure required for that, which the private sector will not develop, has been developed by the public sector.
In terms of the inclusion of young and women, the state is doing a lot. It's even part of the national strategy for financial inclusion. So the financial inclusion has increased a lot, and it was for everyone. And of course, the role of fintech and financial fintech platforms and mobile applications was huge in that.
The Global Findex Database 2025 is now live and offers interactive features that make using the data easier than ever before.
here are four ways you can interact with the data. Heading to Brazil and want to see account ownership for Brazil and its neighbors, go to the Global Findex website and under the Country Figures tab, choose the drop-down menus, any figure in the report, and generate it showing any set of countries. Instantly download these ready-to-use visuals, ideal for supporting your data-driven storytelling in presentations, policy briefs, and research papers. For a comparable set of country spotlights, visit the World Bank's Inclusive Digital Financial Services website. Here, you will find country-level data on digital financial services and digital connectivity. You'll also gain insights to identify inclusion gaps and monitor progress over time. Check out the World Bank's Global Findex Data Bank for raw data that can be used for custom analysis. This platform lets you filter by country, indicator, and year. Create and export custom charts, maps, and reports to use for your own analysis. The World Bank's Data 360 portal is a data analytics platform that provides access to global development data, enabling users to explore, visualize, and analyze key indicators across countries and regions. The Global Findex database is proudly included and readily accessible through the portal. Engage with the Global Findex 2025 data. Explore now at globalfindex.worldbank.org.
Globally, more women are accessing mobile phones, unlocking opportunities, knowledge, and independence. Yet, a digital divide persists. The Global Findex Digital Connectivity Tracker shows that women are 8 percentage points less likely than men to own a phone. Many women rely on shared devices, indicating strong untapped demand. In South Asia and Sub-Saharan Africa, the gap is wider, especially in smartphone ownership. Cost is the main barrier for over half of adults, disproportionately affecting women and low-income users. Safety and harassment concerns further limit women's mobile use. Bridging these gaps is crucial for an inclusive digital future.
Thank you for joining us for the launch of the Global Findex 2025. We extend our deepest gratitude to the more than 750,000 adults worldwide who have generously shared their time and insights into their financial lives through the Global Findex survey since 2011. Their voices are at the heart of this data and make this work possible. We also thank our partners and collaborators who continue to champion financial and digital inclusion and financial health around the world. Dive into the data yourself at globalfindex.worldbank.org.